Hi, this is Jose Luis, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to write a very simple WebSocket client in Python that we're going to connect to all the WebSocket servers that we had in the previous video on this playlist, Fun with WebSockets, so that we can coordinate the motion of this animation ball that I have on the left-hand side and read that information on my Python server, like this. So I'm going to be clicking now. Sorry, I need to actually start the client. So let me start the client. Now we have the client connected, and now any position that I set for this circle is going to be read by this WebSocket Python client, okay? And just to make sure that this sketch is actually living on the cloud, and this client is living on my local machine. So this is also a really nice example of doing network communication between different processes in different parts of the world. So I see someone is trying to hack my video right now, which I'm very happy about because I'm recording this live on my live stream right now. So people who are connected to the chat are checking this out. So that's a really good example of how this can be used to connect anyone in the world through data and through geometry. Woohoo! So let's take a look at how to write a Python WebSocket client. Let's take a look at that. Wonderful. Let's start by the beginning. So full disclosure for this video, I'm not going to get into the weeds of Anaconda environments, Python versions, etc., etc. I'm just going to be using a simple global Python installation that I have on my system, and I'm going to install all my libraries globally in my system, something that is considered bad practice, but I'm just going to be doing a very simple case scenario, so it's not really a big deal. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a terminal, all right? Or you can use your command prompt, you can use PowerShell, whatever you feel more comfortable with. And I'm just going to check that I have a Python version running on my system. So what is this going to be? It's going to be Python 3.9.2. Wonderful. So that works well. So I'm going to rely on you knowing that you have some Anaconda environment or some Python installation on your system. And then the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to install the library that we're going to be using for doing WebSockets in Python, which is going to be called the WebSockets library. And it's literally as simple as installing it with pip. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to type pip install, and I'm going to install the WebSockets library, which I already have installed already, but you would see in your system like, blah, 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 installing something, blah, blah, blah. All right, which means the library is now available on my system, and then I am ready to start typing some coding here. So I'm going to open my Visual Studio Code, which is the development environment that I'm going to be using for this exercise. Before that, I'm going to create a new folder here. I'm going to call this Python WebSockets, for example. I'm going to go in here. I'm going to open a terminal in here, for example, a PowerShell terminal. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new file that I'm going to open right away with my Visual Studio Code. So that's going to be code client.python. And as I do that, it has opened in a different window, but it would be open here. As I save this, all right, this is okay. So it wasn't working as clean as I thought. So I'm just going to create a new text file that is going to be client.py. And then I'm going to drop this in my Visual Studio. And then now I have my Python file. All right. And to make sure that things are working correctly, I'm just going to print a message to the console. Perhaps for this exercise, instead of using these floating terminals, what I may want to do is I may want to use the terminals that come embedded with that can be used directly from Visual Studio. So we're going to try that for this exercise. So instead of opening a standalone terminal, I'm going to open a terminal embedded here inside of Visual Studio. And you can see that this terminal is running here inside of this window. It's a PowerShell terminal, which I very much like, and it's in this random user folder. So what I would like to do is I would like to go to where I have my code. So I'm going to do, I'm going to clear the screen and I'm going to do CD, and then I'm going to paste the route that I copied here from my Windows Explorer. So if I type there, you can see that I have this one file, the client py, which has, right now I just saved it, and now it has like 23 bytes or whatever. And then you can see that if I type Python and then client, I print hello to the console here. All right, so this should work fine. Okay, so we're going to use, I'm actually going to take it back. We're not going to use this right now just because it's too small on the screen. So I'm going to take that back and I'm going to use my terminal here. So I'm going to type here Python client, and then you see how we print here to the console. All right. Okay, so that's going to be one thing. Then what I'm going to do is I would like to create a small WebSocket server client here that is going to connect to the moving dots things that I had previously written in my previous videos on this playlist, Fun with WebSockets. All right. So how is that going to work? Well, the way we're going to do this is, first of all, we're going to import the WebSockets library. And because we have it in our system, it's just going to be installed right away. The other library that I'm going to install is the asynchronous IO library in Python. That is a library that is going to allow me to do things such as running a process and waiting for a response to come from a server. Asynchronous stuff is really good when you're doing client-server communication, because what it does is that it doesn't halt the program that does the request, and it doesn't stop it while it's waiting for the response to come. So asynchronous behavior is actually something that comes out of the box in most of the functions in Node.js, for example, which we have used in the previous videos, but in Python, we have to explicitly use it, because otherwise everything is synchronous. Now, what we do here is we have to define an asynchronous function that is going to be the function that is going to connect to the server. The way we do that in Python is that we use the async keyword, and then we define a function that is going to be called, for example, listening to the server. So I'm going to listen to the server, all right? And then this function is going to be the one that is going to connect to the server and is going to handle whatever comes from the server. All right. So for example, how are we going to do this? I'm going to define a variable called URL, and that URL is going to be the address of the WebSocket server that we had written in Glitch. Okay. So the one that we had for Glitch. Now, the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to connect to the server, and I'm going to do it with another asynchronous function. So I'm going to do asynchronous with websockets.connect to the URL. All right. And then I'm going to make sure that this is a WebSocket variable that we can use then in our code. And then once we have connected, then what we can do is here in the code, we can manage what do we want to do with this, all right? So for example, typically what you would do is you would say, I'm going to define a variable called message. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use await, which is a function, it's a keyword, that what it does is it makes an asynchronous request, and then it waits for that asynchronous request to execute before assigning the value to this value. So that asynchronous request is going to be the WebSocket variable that we just created. I'm going to call this WS just to make things a bit less confusing. WS.receive from the server. And sorry, no semicolons here. And once I got that, I can just print to the console the message that I got received from the server. Okay, wonderful. So now this is great. And I think this is probably going to work with a few modifications that we'll have to do. But now what we need to do is we need to make sure that we actually trigger the execution of this function in an asynchronous way. So the way this is handled in Python with the async.io library is that what we can do is from the async.io, we can fetch what's called the event loop. The event with this function, get event loop. The event loop is basically saying, take the execution of this program, all right, and make sure that that execution is controlled by the function that I'm going to give you. So what we do is, for example, we can say, can you run until this function is complete? Can you run the function listen? And then we pass to this function, we pass the listen function that we just created. What this will do is that it will run this function asynchronously, and it will wait until everything is complete. And we have a bunch of things that need to be completed. First, we need the connection, which is asynchronous, but also receiving a message from the server, which is also asynchronous. Okay? Ooh-hoo, that was a lot of stuff. So let's see if this works. I'm going to save this, and I'm going to clear the screen, and I'm going to start the client. And you can see that nothing happens because the client right now is stuck here waiting to receive a message from the server. So let's give it a message. So if I click here, let me reconnect because this might not be working. You see, as I reconnected, I sent a message, which was the location of the ball. That message was received. But what just happened is that because the message was received and because we set the event loop to run until listen was complete, this function completed, this function completed, and therefore the whole function call also completed. And then the WebSocket client stopped. So that is okay. But what I would like to do is I would like to have a behavior that is a little closer to the one that we had in the previous C# example, where the client stayed alive and kept printing and printing to the console everything that we got, everything that we received from the server. So I'm actually going to use a super, super dirty trick, and I'm sure there's a better way of doing this. So I will be happily corrected by anyone on the comments on this video. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to basically create an infinite loop where I'm going to infinitely be executing this part over and over again. How is that going to be? Well, I can just write a while for loop that is going to be stuck on a true condition. So it's never going to get unstuck from there. And then every time, this is going to be executing continuously because this, the execution is going to pause here, is going to wait for a message, you're going to print that message, and then it's going to execute again, again, and again. This is not great because it will force me to force close the client, but it will do the trick for the time being. So for example, here, you see, and as I move the circle, you can see how I'm getting and printing to the console all the normalized coordinates of this circle. All right. So great. So we just wrote a WebSocket client that we can use to listen to data that is coming from the server. What we could do with this client now is we could take this data, we could parse the JSON object, which is a very easy thing to do in Python, actually. And then we could do that to print some ASCII art on the, so an ASCII rectangle with the position of the circle here on the console. But I'm actually going to leave that to you, the viewer. You're welcome to check my previous videos on how I did that with C#, and you're welcome to implement your own version here in Python. And if you do it nicely, feel free to send me a link to your GitHub repo, and we can, or post it here in the comments so that other people can see your code, okay? All right, wonderful. So I think what I'm going to do in the next video now is I'm going to teach you how to write a simple WebSocket server using Python. Okay. If you like what you saw, please consider subscribing, pressing the notifications button, liking this video, etc. And I'll see you on the next video, creating a WebSocket server with Python.